Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, let's see how to group and filter the items of View Multiselect drop-down component of Synfusion. If you look at this online example, you can see the Multiselect drop-down displaying different book names. These books are grouped under different categories like comics, science fiction, and thriller. You can also filter the specific book names that matches your typed-in characters. I will show you now how to group and filter the multi-select drop-down items using my Getting Started application. Let me open my existing View application where I have added the View multi-select drop-down with remote data. If you want to know how to create a simple View multi-select drop-down, then you can listen to my Getting Started video, the link for which is shown in the above YouTube card. Also, you can download this Getting Started example from the GitHub link, which I have shared in the description part below. Now, to have better clarity and focus on these grouping and filtering features, I am replacing the remote data with JSON data collection, which contains an array of objects with two fields, namely name and ID. Also, I have mapped the name field to text property and ID field to value property. I have assigned vegetable names to data source, so let me change the placeholder property value as select a vegetable. Also, ensure whether this data item and data fields variables are assigned to the data source and fields property of the multi-select drop-down. So here, you can see the multi-select drop-down showing the vegetable names. Now, let me show you the steps to group these multi-select drop-down items. For that, I need to define the one more field category with appropriate values on each of the existing data source. Then, I will map this newly defined data source field category to the group by option within the fields property of multi-select drop-down component. As the data item and data fields variables are already assigned to the data source and fields property of the multi-select drop-down, so let me show you the output directly. Now, when you look at the multi-select drop-down, the data items are grouped under the category leafy and salad and beans. Suppose, if you would like to select the entire group items in a single selection, then you need to use enable group checkbox and mode properties. To select the entire group items in a single selection, first, I need to import multi-select and checkbox selection from Synfusion EJ2 View Dropdowns package. Also, let me inject the module checkbox selection in the multi-select to use the checkbox. Here, to enable checkbox for group headers, I will define the property enable group checkbox and set its value as true to the multi-select drop-down code. Then, I need to set the mode property as checkbox, which configures the checkbox mode for multi-select drop-down interaction. So now, you can see the multi-select drop-down where the group headers and items are displayed with checkboxes. When I select the beans header, all the items under this beans header are shown in the selected state. Next, I will show you how to filter the data items on the multi-select drop-down based on the characters I type on this search box. To start filtering the data items, first, I need to enable the filtering feature in multi-select drop-down. For that, let me define the property allow filtering and set its value as true inside the multi-select drop-down code. Look at the multi-select drop-down now. When I start to type in some characters here, you can see the pop-up displaying the vegetable names that starts with my typed in text. You can notice here, by default, the casing of the typed in characters are ignored during the filtering action on multi-select drop-down. But if I want to consider the characters with same casing as I type in, then I need to set false to the ignore case property. So here, you can see the multi-select drop-down. When I type in some characters in lower case, then you can see the multi-select drop-down with no records as there are no items matching my typed in characters in the same casing. Next, Let me proceed to explain about the filter types of multi-select dropdown. By default, starts with filter type is applied while filtering the data items on multi-select dropdown, but you can also filter the multi-select dropdown items based on the other two filter types, namely ends with or contains. Now, I will proceed to filter the items based on the end characters of data items. So, I will define the property filter type and set its value as ends with inside the multi-select dropdown code. And now, if I type in some characters here, you can see the pop-up showing the vegetable names that ends with my typed in characters. Similarly, you can also apply contains filter type if you want to filter the data items that contains your typed in characters at any of its position. Finally, let me show you how to do filtering with diacritic characters in the text. Usually, when I try to filter the items that has some diacritic characters, it will be ignored during filtering. To show the working of diacritic filtering, first, let me modify the data source by including it with some diacritic characters. Then, I will define the property ignore accent to the multi-select dropdown code and set its value as true. Here, I'm going to filter the data items which starts with characters by ignoring the case, so let me remove the filter type and ignore case properties. As I have assigned the array of strings with diacritic characters to the multi-select dropdown data source, so I will remove the fields property which is not needed. Now, when you look at this multi-select dropdown, you can see the pop-up displaying the filtered data items that includes the diacritic characters. Okay, let me summarize some of the important points now. We have seen how to group the view multi-select dropdown items as well as how to filter those items. Also, we have seen the supported filter types in multi-select dropdown and how to apply those filters as well as how to include diacritic characters while filtering. If you'd like to see the working of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link which is shared in the description part below. Also, if you find this video as useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos. Thanks for watching this video.